your hands. You could smell it for a while.
It's a sad and smelly situation. Tens of thousands of dead fish. Now the federal government says it's giving up on its plan to drain a Delta island. That draining started earlier this month, but last week when thousands of rotting fish carcasses started making a stink, so did the local fishermen.
Prospect Island is located about 20 miles south of Sacramento. KCRA 3's David Beanick tonight with what the feds are planning to do now.
With hip waders and hand nets, fish and game workers today began the very unpleasant task of removing thousands of dead fish from the thick and slippery mud covering Prospect Island.
Just to improve the water quality for the remaining fish that are there.
It'll help keep the other fish alive?
Yeah, a little better chance of survival.
The federal government owns this 1,200-acre island, which repeated levee breaks had caused to flood. Feds patched the breaks and started to pump the water out until fishermen like Dwayne Schrader noticed the fish left to die and rot.
Oh, that's sick. That's ridiculous. It's wholesale slaughter is what it is.
And it's not just fish that are dying. As the water went down, also left high and dry, these Delta crawdads.
So today, the feds pulled out the water pumps and plan to replace them soon with air pumps, which will oxygenate the water enough to keep the remaining fish alive.
Well, the fish and game folks tell us they think they can all be saved, once we begin putting some oxygen back into the water.
The cleanup can't come soon enough for people like Tony Zapata, who says the smell of rotting fish is not only strong, but also lingering.
You rub your hand in cat food or something, it'll stay on your hands. You could smell it for a while.
Tonight, the federal government says it's still hoping to eventually sell this property, but it's not clear who would want to buy it, since more than 20% of the island is still underwater and about to become, essentially, a huge outdoor aquarium. On Prospect Island, David Beanick, KCRA 3 reports.
The State Fish and Game Department says it has launched a criminal investigation into how and why all those fish were killed. The federal government says it followed all the rules.